Let's continue with the video on dissection. Alright, four circles are touching each other as shown, and we have to find the area enclosed in between. Join the four centers and what we get is a square. Now this area in fluorescent is what we have to find. Let's focus on just the square. The required area is area of a square minus the area of four quarter circles. Now these quarter circles can be rearranged to form one full circle. So this is side square minus pi r square. 4 minus pi is the answer. Next question. This came in CAT 2003. Two equal square pieces of clothes are taken and from the first piece, one circle of maximum size is cut. Whereas the second cloth is divided into squares of different sizes and from each square, circle of maximum size is cut. Now we have to find the ratio of this remaining red region to blue region. Ratio of the remaining pieces of cloth in both the cases. Now as I have been saying again and again, most of the times, yes, these two areas are equal. But why? For a general case of a circle of radius r inside a square of side s, this is the ratio of area of circle to area of a square. Now if I scale up the diagram 4 times, that means the new side of a square will be 4 times the old side and new radius will also be 4 times the old radius. And when we take the ratio of areas, 4 square and 4 square will get cancelled and we get the same old ratio of area, right? So this was our first case of cloth and a bigger circle. Now if I take this smaller figure multiple times, let's say 4 times. Now the area of circle and square will also become 4 times because we have 4 circles and 4 squares, right? So in overall ratio of areas, 4 and 4 will get cancelled and the ratio will remain same only. So ratio in both the cases is same. So area of cut upon area of whole cloth is a constant, right? Area of cut, that is area of circle, upon area of whole cloth, that is area of square. This is constant. This ratio is constant. We have seen this. This is same in both the cases, right? Also, area of whole cloth is same in both the cases. We took cloth of same size in both the cases. So, area of cut will also be same in both the cases. And therefore, the area of remaining cloth will also be same in both the cases. As the cut part is same in both the cases, the remaining part will also be same in both the cases. Next, we have a question from CAT 2005. Find the area of this leaf-like figure inscribed in a square of unit side. Now this figure can be considered as two overlapping quarter circles minus the square. Can you see the quarter circles overlapping? Basically, this leaf area is coming twice. So on subtracting the square area, we'll have the required area once. Area of quarter circle is area of complete circle upon 4. So pi r square upon 4 minus the area of a square, that is 1 square. Pi by 2 minus 1 is the answer. There is another way we can proceed about this. The quarter circle can be extended to form a semicircle. Radius will remain same, 1 unit. Now this leaf can be divided into two equal parts from which one part can be placed like this. Now the area of shaded portion is area of semicircle minus the area of triangle. Area of semicircle is pi into 1 square upon 2 minus area of triangle is half base is 2 into height is 1. So this again is pi by 2 minus 1. Once this leaf figure is sorted, we can easily deal with difficult figures like these, right? Another interesting figure is this one. an inverted Diwali lamp shape formed using two semicircles and one quarter circle. Now, we have seen how to find the area of this green colored leaf. If a small quarter circle's radius is 1 unit, area of leaf is pi by 2 minus 1. What about area of this blue region? It would be area of bigger quarter circle minus area of this orange square minus the area of two smaller quarter circles colored in green, right? So area is pi into 2 square by 4. This is area of bigger quarter circle minus area of a square is 1 square minus area of two smaller quarter circles. It's 2 times pi into 1 square by 4. This is equal to pi by 2 minus 1. Basically, area of green region is equal to area of blue region. Same could be said in this figure formed by connecting 4 of the lamp-shaped figure. Area in green is equal to area in blue. Another question can be made by slightly changing this figure. In this case, the non-shaded area, or we can say the white, the area in white is equal to the colored area, that is area in green plus area in blue. Why? Well, this can be seen by breaking the leaf and placing its parts like this. Non-shaded area and shaded area are separated by diagonal, so they are equal. The last figure of our dissection and discussion is regular hexagon. It could be divided into 6 equilateral triangles. This we have already seen. If a side length is given, area of hexagon will be 6 times the area of equilateral triangle. That is 6 times root 3 upon 4 side square. Make a few more cuts and we get 12 congruent right triangles. So in this figure, what is the ratio of area of shaded region to area of hexagon? It will be 4 triangles upon 12 triangles, 4:12 or 1:3. We can also divide the hexagon into 3 rhombuses, each with area 1/3 of the area of hexagon, right? If I join the alternate vertices of the hexagon and make a triangle, what would be the ratio of area of this triangle to area of hexagon? This was asked in CAD 2003. Now I have made it very simple for you by drawing the rhombuses. Each side of the red triangle is cutting the rhombus into 2 equal halves. So area inside the triangle is equal to area outside the triangle, right? And ratio of area of triangle to area of hexagon will be 1/2, okay? We are almost done for this video. Just solve this last question and we'll wrap up. Side is given. Area of hexagon will be 6 times the area of equilateral triangle. 6 into root 3 by 4, 6 square, that is 54 root 3. Now draw all the 6 triangles and then draw all the medians inside these triangles. This is one more way to dissect a regular hexagon. Hexagon is divided into 6 equilateral triangles and each equilateral triangle is divided into 6 smaller right triangles of equal areas. Medians divide a triangle into smaller triangles of equal areas, right? So in total, 6 into 6, 36 smaller right triangles are formed with equal areas, out of which 4 triangles are shaded, okay? So ratio of shaded area to hexagon's area will be 4 upon 36, that is 1 upon 9. And shaded area will be 1 upon 9 into area of hexagon, that is 1 upon 9 into 54 root 3, that is 6 root 3. So these were the most common figures that we have seen till now: triangle, square, rectangle and hexagon. I hope video 1 and this video 2 of area through dissection helped in giving a different perspective altogether to look at these figures. Thank you for watching.